In June 2007, Jeremy Harper of Birmingham, Alabama, set up a live stream in his apartment. Then he started counting. People around the world watched him utter more than 11,000 numbers a day on average. Some viewers even sent him stuff. Food, money, a yo-yo. Certain donations, all of which he gave to charity, came with goofy requests like, do the chicken dance. After 89 days, 89 days without seeing the sun, without any privacy except for bathroom breaks, Harper finally hit 1 million. And with that, he earned the Guinness World Record for the highest number ever counted out loud. Hi, I'm Erin McCarthy, editor-in-chief of mentalfloss.com, and I've decided that Harper deserves another honor too. Weirdest world record ever achieved in Alabama. On this episode of The List Show, we're running through every US state's strangest Guinness World Record, from gargantuan salad fodder in Alaska to Wyoming's longest beard chain. Before we dive in though, three quick disclaimers. One, all of these records are from Guinness. So if you know somebody who can hold more bowling balls at one time than a Utah, tell Guinness, not us. Two, said record holders aren't necessarily from the state, but they broke the record in the state. Third, and most important, all information is accurate as of when we recorded. Now that that's out of the way, let's get started. While Jeremy Harper was busy counting down in Alabama, Scott Robb was growing the world's heaviest kale up in Palmer, Alaska. In August 2007, he showed off the specimen at the Alaska State Fair, where it tipped the scales at 105 pounds, 14.5 ounces. Robb holds other hefty veggie records too, including heaviest turnip, 39.2 pounds, heaviest kohlrabi, almost 97 pounds, and heaviest green cabbage, 138.25 pounds. Did he sell the family cow in exchange for magic beans? Just wondering. That's a Stephen Sondheim joke, and if you don't get it, I don't know what to tell you. Colossal produce is to Scott Robb what whip tricks are to Adam Crack Winrich. The whip-cracking enthusiast has more than 30 Guinness World Records to his name, achieved at various Renaissance fairs and other events across the country. At the Arizona Renaissance Festival Fair Park in 2014, Winrich clinched the record for most candles extinguished by a whip in 1 minute. 102. At the same fair the following year, Winrich, with the help of his assistant Dakota Granados, nabbed most bottles caught with a whip in 1 minute. The total was 18, which is about 18 more than I could do. In November 2017, at an indoor pool at the University of Arkansas, Lindsay Scott put on and took off her wetsuit in 43.13 seconds, setting a record for the fastest time to put on and take off a wetsuit. Scott was in a McDonald's parking lot when she got the news that Guinness had officially approved the record. As she told the Southwest Times Record, "I just started crying, and I was trying to get my Egg McMuffin, and it was a mess." So she probably also deserves a world record for being the first person to learn they set a world record while waiting for an Egg McMuffin. No matter what number you think could earn someone a record for the most bobby pins in a beard, I guarantee you, it's too low. California hairstylist Dean Banowitz, also known as the Hollywood Hair Guy, currently holds the title for fitting 4,831 pins in his beard on July 21st, 2021. Let that sink in. 4,831. Ouch. In Estes Park, Colorado, during July of 2022, siblings Matt Chojnacki and Sharon Van Zeeland led their families to victory in a very specific arena. Fastest time for a team of eight people to wrap a person with wrapping paper. The record-setting time was an impressive 41.1 seconds. As of filming this video, there's no record holder for fastest time for an individual to wrap a person with wrapping paper. If you see me buying a million rolls of wrapping paper at Target later, no, you didn't. Connecticut's John Reznikoff is widely regarded as one of the world's foremost authenticators of historical artifacts. In Guinness World Record books, he's known as the guy with the largest collection of hair from historical figures. His trove features tresses from 115 different people, including Elvis, Napoleon, Marilyn Monroe, and King Charles I. He even has a lock taken from Abraham Lincoln on his deathbed, complete with specks of dried brain matter. The New York Times once likened that residue to egg bits found on a frying pan. Look, if I have to picture it, so do you. During Delaware State University's fall open house in 2019, 1,661 students and other attendees buzzed simultaneously, originating the Guinness World Record for most people buzzing simultaneously. Tony Boyle, DSU's Vice President of Strategic Enrollment, had chosen buzzing as a nod to the school's mascot, a hornet. That same day, DSU also broke the record for most people waving foam fingers simultaneously, with 1,709 participants. I guess trying for most people buzzing and waving foam fingers simultaneously was just a bridge too far. When Tina Ackles and Thomas Rogers tied the knot in Safety Harbor, Florida in 2015, Their wedding party was larger than many couples' entire guest list is. Ackles had 168 bridesmaids, breaking a record for most bridesmaids to one bride. Ackles was a member of the American Businesswomen's Association, and she and Rogers decided to pair visiting the association's annual conference with their wedding. I can only imagine most of the presents were those little pens they give you at check-in that never actually work. Do robots perform in rap battles? Fortunately, that's not the title of any Philip K. Dick fanfic. Well, that I know of. But perhaps unfortunately, the answer to the question is yes. In February 2020, the Georgia Institute of Technology posted a YouTube video in which human rapper Dash Smith rap battled a robot named Shimon, created by Gil Weinberg. The competition earned Shimon a Guinness World Record as the first robot to participate in a rap battle. Shimon's rhymes were a little unintelligible, to be honest, but I could definitely make out the sentence, "You're trying to make a claim I want to be human." Also, the word indigestion. In short, the record for the first robot to win a rap battle is still up for grabs. For most people, February 3rd, 2018 lasted 24 hours. For Paul Morgan, who turned 28 that day, it was twice as long. Morgan celebrated his birthday by jet-setting across time zones in order to break the Guinness World Record for longest birthday ever. The previous record was 46 hours. Morgan's lasted a full 48. He started his trip in Apia, Samoa, then flew to Auckland, New Zealand, then to Los Angeles, and finally to Kauai in Hawaii, where he celebrated with a hard-earned day at the beach. For one tense moment on the 12.5-hour flight from Auckland to LA, Morgan thought he might fail his attempt. He needed to cross the international dateline during a specific hour in order to stay in the same day, but the plane was in danger of hitting it too early. It worked out in the end, but just by a hair. If the plane had crossed just a minute and a half earlier, Morgan told Guinness World Records, I would have crossed back into the previous day and lost all the time I had accrued up to that point. Is this making your brain hurt worse than a time travel movie? Because me too. On October 8th, 2022 in Boise, Idaho, David Rush blew a single green pea 84 feet and 11 inches. The feat, which earned him the world record for the farthest distance to blow a pea, was accomplished with just one breath. But he was allowed to break up that breath into a few shorter bursts. It was Rush's 250th Guinness World Record. And no, most Guinness World Records isn't one of them. That unofficial honor goes to Ashrita Furman, who has set more than 700 records since 1979. You'll hear more about some of his stunts later on in this video. Stepping on one Lego brick is bad enough. Imagine walking roughly 5.5 miles on them. That's what Salaknib Sunny Molina of Woodstock, Illinois, did in May 2021, setting a new world record for the farthest distance walking barefoot on Lego bricks. The exact distance was 29,195 feet, 10.39 inches. I hope his first words after finishing were, "That was child's play." In May 2022, Indiana-based recycling firm Technology Recyclers decided to raise awareness for recycling electronics by rather unorthodox methods, namely winning a Guinness World Record for the most laptops toppled in a domino fashion. The magic number was 2,910. Turns out, toppling items in a domino fashion is a rich record category. There are also titles for books, coins, bricks, bottles, boxes of gum, picture frames, disposable hygiene products, cereal boxes, and mint dispensers, among other things. And yes, other things includes dominoes, toppled in a domino fashion. On April 29th, 2013, comedian David Scott started his stand-up show at the Diamond Joe Casino in Dubuque, Iowa, and kept going for 40 hours, 8 minutes, setting a record for longest stand-up comedy show by an individual. He later explained some of the logistics behind the record attempt to a news outlet. He was allowed a 5-minute break every hour for the bathroom, had to wait 4 hours before retelling a joke, and had to physically hold the microphone in his hand. And what about the audience? He said that one woman watched the first 12 hours, went home, and returned for the last 8. And I feel bad for getting more popcorn during a movie. In 2000, teenager Andy Wiltz wowed the crowd of a variety show at a high school in Topeka, Kansas by leapfrogging over 4 people. No trampoline, no nothing, just a running start and a really good push off from the shoulders of the first guy in line. And he didn't stop there. The next leap was over 6 fearless volunteers, then 8, then 9, and finally 10. To this day, that's still the record for the most people leapfrogged over in a single bound. And you know what? I think that's plenty. Lexington, Kentucky is home to the world's largest religious-themed miniature golf course. It's located at the Lexington Ice Center and Sports Complex, and it's called, wait for it, Fairway to Heaven. There are 3 18-hole courses, that's 54 holes in total, and each hole is inspired by a different scene from the Bible. Noah's Ark, David and Goliath, Jonah and the Whale, Jesus changing water into wine, they play all the hits. The first course focuses on the Old Testament, and the second is the New Testament, and the third is miracles. And on the eighth day, God invented mini golf, or so I assume. On March 5th, 2023 in New Orleans, performer Dan Block clinched the world record for fastest time to model a balloon dog sculpture through the nose, just over 35 and a half seconds. You might have some follow-up questions such as, what does that even mean? Well, first, he threads a long, uninflated balloon into his nose and pulls one end out of his mouth. Then he uses a small pump to inflate the balloon and twists it into the shape of a dog while half of it's hanging out of his nose and the other half is hanging out of his mouth. Kids, don't try that at home, and I will not be trying it either. Plenty of cosplayers flaunt costumes so good you think they'd belong on the big screen. But only one of those cosplayers holds the Guinness World Record for the most functional gadgets in a cosplay suit. That man is Portland, Maine's Keith Dinsmore, whose 2019 Batman costume featured 30 gadgets, including a flashlight, smoke bombs, handcuffs, a first aid kit, a bat signal torch, and, of course, a portable USB charger, because Gotham is screwed if Batman's phone dies during a mission. Dinsmore's wife, Molly, is an avid cosplayer, too. The couple first connected over their shared love of suiting up as the Caped Crusader. She was definitely really proud of her husband's achievement. But when he initially told her about his plans to build a record-breaking bat suit, she exercised affectionate skepticism. As she told Guinness World Records, I kind of rolled my eyes and said, sure, honey. It's only fitting that Maryland's weirdest world record involves a creature found in the Chesapeake Bay region. It's not the blue crab, though the state is also home to the record for largest crab cake, which weighed a whopping 300 pounds. No, I'm talking about Pisteria piscicida, a type of single-cell dinoflagellate that was implicated in the deaths of tens of thousands of fish in Maryland's Pocomoke River in 1997. It was also blamed for some health issues for humans who came in contact with it, including temporary memory loss. And for that, Pisteria piscicida holds the Guinness World Record for smallest organism to cause amnesia in humans. One specimen is only about 0.02 millimeter long, so yeah, that's pretty small. I should point out that how much blame this little guy should get has been fiercely debated for decades. It very well might be innocent of the fish kill charges, and the memory loss charges are more of an open question. But that's a story for another time, because rightly or wrongly, it has a Guinness World Record. How many tea bags would you need to throw into mugs in 30 seconds to earn a Guinness title? More than 13, which is what current record holder Dan Douglas of Jefferson, Massachusetts, accomplished in April 2022. And if there were an official record for most tea dumped in a harbor, well, we all know that Massachusetts would hold that too. Let's talk about joggling, which is juggling while jogging or jogging while juggling, because apparently some people think that those two activities aren't hard enough on their own. Eric Walter is such a talented joggler that in 2013, Guinness recognized him as the fastest man to ever joggle a kilometer with three objects. He did it in 2 minutes and 46.63 seconds. For reference, the fastest regular non-joggling kilometer in history was run in about 2 minutes and 12 seconds. Walter's record-setting kilometer event happened in Adrian, Michigan, but he set other joggling records elsewhere, including fastest 400 meters in Ohio and fastest 800 meters in Indiana. If you're, say, an iPhone user with a Gmail address, you probably know that Apple and Google have different versions of the same emojis. Sometimes they look different enough that their meanings seem different, too. In 2016, researchers from a lab at the University of Minnesota's Department of Computer Science and Engineering published a study in which participants rated various iterations of emojis across five different platforms in terms of positive, negative, or neutral. For one emoji in particular, the responses were so varied that it now holds the Guinness World Record for most confusing emoji. It's Microsoft's edition of what the study calls the smiling face with open mouth and tightly closed eyes. 54% of participants labeled it positive, while 44% said it was negative. Is it crying out in pain or laughing so hard it's squinting? The answer is ambiguous enough that you just might want to avoid using it altogether. Every year, Mississippi State University kicks off football season with a massive pep rally called the Cowbell Yell. In 2015, students did their school proud by setting a new Guinness World Record for most people ringing cowbells simultaneously. The grand total was 5,748, smashing the previous record of just 640, set in Switzerland back in 2009. But the real record was how many people shouted, "I need more cowbell!" during the event. Or so I assume. Is that a good Christopher Walken impression or what? If anything fosters community more than ringing cowbells at a pep rally, it's got to be patting your head and rubbing your stomach in a crowd of 1,132 people. Missouri's Kirkwood School District did exactly that in 2014, earning participants a joint world record for the most people patting their heads and rubbing their stomachs. Unclear if anyone got disqualified for accidentally rubbing their head and patting their stomach. I wonder if I could read one of these. For 35 years, the Rock Creek Lodge in Clinton, Montana was home to the Testicle Festival, a celebration involving live music, alcohol, and the excessive consumption of deep-fried bull testicles. Each year, an estimated 5,600 pounds, or more than 2.5 tons, of animal gonads were devoured by testicle enthusiasts. Organizers finally called it quits in 2018 due to what they deemed a negative community reaction, fights, lawsuits, and safety issues. Cows are not usually known for their personality or their ability to be trained. But Ghost, a 4-year-old bovine in Nebraska, was taught by owner Megan Riemann to perform 10 tricks. Ghost can come when called, spin, nod her head, and even bow. Now, I know what you're thinking. Sure, a cow can do all that in 3 minutes, maybe even 2 minutes. But Ghost did it all and more in just 1 minute in March 2023. Riemann said horse training techniques helped her teach Ghost, who improved her original time with plenty of hay as a reward. When you think cool, you think fuzzy dice hanging from your rearview mirror. Or at least you did in the 1950s. At any rate, Las Vegas is where cool always prevails, which is why the city holding the record for the world's largest fuzzy dice makes all kinds of sense. These mega dice measured 4 feet on all sides and were rolled out by the city's Convention and Visitors Authority in 2011. And no, Wayne Newton was not on hand for the unveiling. Everyone knows about the Barrel of Monkeys, the incredibly cheap but fun toy that features tiny plastic primates stuffed into a container. In 2012, Dartmouth senior D. Parker Finney created an interlocking chain of monkeys. The record-setting distance was an incredible 1,143 feet, which totaled nearly 6,000 plastic monkeys. The Garden State has a few things to boast about, including the most shoes sorted in 1 minute and the world's oldest tick, which is about 90 million years thanks to being frozen in amber. But the real pride comes from having the world's longest ribbon in a ribbon-cutting ceremony. In 2013, the state reopened the Jersey Shore after Hurricane Sandy by draping a 5.51-mile-long ribbon along the coastline. In 2014, Guinness bestowed recognition upon slinky enthusiast Susan Suazo of Las Lunas, New Mexico for her collection of 1,054 slinky toys. And no, the items were not identical. Susan had 1,054 entirely different slinky products in her possession. Metal, plastic, vending machine, and promotional items. In 2021, Susan told Toy Tales that she now owned 2,000 slinky toys and plans to talk to Guinness about her equally impressive fly swatter collection. Susan added that she once brought home a 12-inch slinky that was deemed suspicious in her luggage and prompted a visit from the FBI, who believed it might have been a bomb. Dogs love shoes, but not even the most shoe-loving of dogs could manage to yank a shoe off their owner's foot in record time. Then there was Lilu, a trained Belgian Malinois who, on the set of the 2013 talk show Katie, managed to pull a total of 12 shoes off in just 1 minute. Lilu also ripped away 20 socks on a different show, Guinness World Records Unleashed, but that record fell in 2023 when a dog named Daiquiri took off 21 socks in Milan, Italy. Ant farms. Fun for kids, a nightmare scenario for parents. But no ant farm could instill more terror than the one created by pest control service Terminix in 2019. Temporarily located at Discovery Place Science in Charlotte, North Carolina, the ant farm measured 4 feet by 3 feet by 3 inches thick. North Dakota is famous for a few things, many of them related to how cold it gets in winter, which makes it a fitting place to have the record for the most people making snow angels simultaneously, a feat accomplished in 2007 when 8,962 people all got together to make snow angels. Here's a fun fact. When you type Wyoming, which is the least populated state, into Guinness's search bar, you get 36 results. No spoilers on which one we'll be picking. But for North Dakota, you only get 11. As of filming, they are most people making snow angels simultaneously, first use of a fire shelter, tallest male politician, fastest half marathon dressed in an American football kit, largest scrap metal sculpture, largest wooden baseball bat, fastest swim 200 meter individual medley SM8 female, longest journey by a street sailor, longest piece of siding, first drone assisted criminal conviction, and oldest freshwater fish. It's possible that there might be more, but the people of North Dakota need to start breaking more records. And because I know that the curiosity will probably keep you up at night, the longest piece of siding was 236 feet 9 inches installed in a building in Fargo. We all gotta go sometime. And if you want to get in the ground as quickly as possible, you might want to consider hiring Jose Luis Rivera, who put his digging skills to the test in 2018 in Cleveland, Ohio. He was able to dig a person-sized grave in exactly 2 hours. Nothing's more satisfying than the fist bump, a show of camaraderie that also lets people know you're serious about avoiding germs. In 2011, a large group of students at the Oklahoma Association of Student Councils in Skiatook set the record for the most simultaneous fist bumps, a total of 1,820. Haven't we all thought about alphabetizing the letters in a can of alphabet soup? Well, Jacob Chandler of Gresham, Oregon didn't just dream it. He made it happen. In 2021, Jacob sorted out the entire alphabet in 2 minutes, 8.6 seconds. This required a lot of strategy, as the bowl and even spoon needed to be just right in order to efficiently separate the letters from the soup. In 1979, reader John Sulzbog sent a letter to his local newspaper, the Upper Dauphin Sentinel. This paper gave readers space to speak their mind. How do we know? Because John sent in a letter over 25,000 words long, or about a quarter of your average novel. The Sentinel published it over 8 installments. It was reportedly about the Civil War. If you're aiming to sew the world's biggest sock, you need a team of expert sewers. Once you have that team, there's no limit to the size of sock you can make. A team known as the Rhode Island Sewing Network teamed up with nonprofit Project Undercover to create a sock in 2011 that measured 32 feet 7 inches tall by 22 feet 6 inches wide and 8 feet 2 inches thick. Think business sock more than thick cotton, though. Kenneth Huggins of Columbia, South Carolina has assembled the mightiest collection of toasters in the world. When he nabbed the record in 2012, he had 1,284 toasters, enough to require a separate building from his house to store them all. Single slice, double slice, four slice, Ken had it all. Huggins is also a member of the Toaster Collectors Association, which has more than 680 members on Facebook. That also has to be some kind of record, but we can't confirm it. The Black Hills area of South Dakota is susceptible to some pretty dramatic weather, and on January 22, 1943, it got extreme. Arctic air from Canada competed with warmer air from the Pacific. The result was some of the most sensational temperature changes in recorded history. In Spearfish, the temperature went from 4 degrees Fahrenheit to 45 degrees in just 2 minutes. A couple of hours later, when the temperature was up to 54 degrees, it plummeted to negative 4 degrees, a change of 58 degrees in 27 minutes. Glass actually cracked. In 2017, Ashrita Furman set a Guinness World Record by popping an astounding 40 balloons in 30 seconds using only his mouth. Now, I know what you're saying. Why not go for the gold and see how many balloons you can pop in 1 minute? Ashrita did exactly that, getting 64 in Malaysia in 2020. He also holds records for most balloons burst by sitting, 50 in 30 seconds done in New York, and the most balloons burst with a fork. 197 in 1 minute, done in London. We all know stop, drop, and roll. It's a device used to help us remember how we can assist ourselves when we're on fire and perhaps not thinking too clearly because we are engulfed in flames. To raise awareness, firefighters in League City, Texas organized a massive stop, drop, and roll demonstration at Challenger Columbia Stadium in 2018. A total of 1,989 volunteers spun themselves on the field for 30 seconds, surpassing the previous record by nearly 300 people. A bowling ball weighs between 6 and 16 pounds, and even one of them is fairly heavy, so try holding 16 of them. That's what Chad McLean did in 2020 in Brigham City, Utah, setting the record. By the way, a good rule of thumb when choosing a bowling ball is to find one that's roughly 10% or less of your body weight. No matter what kind of footwear you have, or even none at all, walking a tightrope is always full of tension. That's why we call stressful events high wire acts. Vermont high schooler Ariana Wunderly took it a step further, pun most definitely intended, in 2022 when she walked 639 feet and 7 inches on a tightrope while wearing high heels. That meant she had to crisscross the rope 52 times. They say lightning never strikes the same place twice. Unfortunately for Roy Sullivan, it seems to have struck him with almost cosmically vengeful regularity. Roy was a park ranger in Virginia who was hit by lightning a record 7 times between 1942 and 1977. Some of the hits took a toenail or singed his hair, while others caused skin burns. Roy's notoriety earned him the nickname the Spark Ranger. Incredibly, even his wife got struck once. The odds of your average person being hit even one time in a given year are 1 in 1.22 million. Here's one to make you weep. In 2010, Bob Bloomer attended the Walla Walla Sweet Onion Festival in Walla Walla, Washington, and set a record for the fastest time to peel 50 pounds of onions, Holding back tears, Bob took care of 50 pounds, which amounted to 31 onions. If 80s artist Lisa Frank taught us anything, it's that unicorns are awesome. In 2022, the people of Charleston, West Virginia had to confront this reality with a gathering of 334 people who had all donned unicorn horns. There's no telling what sort of hearing loss was suffered by spectators in Port Washington, Wisconsin, who witnessed 800 riding lawnmowers parade down their streets in 1997. Another mower record involves balancing one on your chin. That's 7 minutes, 2.06 seconds, and it's held by balloon enthusiast Ashrita Furman, who nabbed the record in the Netherlands. Most balloons destroyed by a riding lawnmower is not yet a record, but it's only a matter of time. Casper, Wyoming was home to the National Beard and Mustache Championships in 2022. And if you're wondering what sort of business is conducted there, it's pretty much what you'd expect. The world's longest chain of beards was 150 feet, 10.75 inches, and involved 69 individuals who stood next to each other and linked their facial hair, which had to be at least 7.8 inches long, using hair clips. The chain was measured from the first nose to the last. Unions help to fight for workers' rights, and while many have acronyms, for others, brevity just will not do. In Washington, a labor union took the record for the longest name. It was the International Association of Marble, Slate, and Stone Polishers, Rubbers and Sawyers, Tile and Marble Setters Helpers, and Marble Mosaic and Terrazzo Workers Helpers. The union is no longer active, probably because chanting that during a strike would be exhausting. We also consider telling you about a Sumatran porcupine, believed to have been the most senior vermin of them all, at 27 years, 3 months, that lived in the district's National Zoological Park. But we didn't want to make a joke about the oldest rodent in Washington. Feel free to add your own, and thanks for watching.